Hey, what's up? It's Travis. Before I do this review of Paranormal Activity 3, I have to be honest with you. This set is haunted. This movie starts right up. I don't even remember seeing a title sequence. There's these two sisters, Katie and Christy, and they seem like two normal kids having fun, talking to imaginary friends. What? Toby, shut up. What the f*** was that for? Anyways, things start to get a little paranormal around the house. The story that takes place in this movie is what started it all with Paranormal Activity 1 and Paranormal Activity 2. It's kind of like a pre-prequel, because Paranormal Activity 2 was the prequel, and now this is before that. These little girls are the same characters as the girls in Paranormal Activity 1 and Paranormal Activity 2. They're just children in this one, obviously. So this shows you how it all started. I thought it was cool in this one how they showed that this entity, this demon, was actually friendly at first. And then it becomes a what the hell was that? I'm sure the Paranormal Activity franchise is thankful that the father figure in this movie turned out to be a wedding videographer. How convenient. And it's interesting to me that there's paranormal activity going on in this house, and nobody's like, well, maybe we should just leave. What? Why are you looking at me like that? Thought I heard something. I'd be scared out of my mind. I'd be like, get me the f*** out of here. I'd be like, peace, I'm out, bitch. Anytime there's little kids in scary movies, it's all bad. Like Poltergeist, for example. That movie gave me nightmares. The little girls did a great job acting, by the way. Oh, the light's going off, huh? Huh. Anyway, I'm not gonna lie. In scary movies, I jump like a bitch, and there are tons of jump scares in this movie. What I've come to realize with the Paranormal Activity movies is that people either love them or they hate them. There's no in-between on these ones. And most of the time, it's the people who believe in ghosts that actually like these movies. Kinda like me. I feel like this is the closest thing to what a real-life haunting would be like. What? Why are you looking at me like that? Ah! Anyways, for entertainment, I'm gonna give this movie an 8. Go watch this in the theaters. Bring some girls because you know how they love to do that scream thing and maybe they'll fall in your lap. We have a very special guest on this show today. He actually went with us to the midnight showing of Paranormal Activity 3. You might have heard of him, you may have not heard of him. He's got like thousands of subscribers on YouTube. His name is Azurite Reaction. So if you have not heard of him, look him up. He's awesome, he's got great videos. And if you have heard of them, then you know. So what did you think, man?
Well, as most people who've seen my videos and stuff like that know, I'm a pretty cynical guy when it comes to scary movies and stuff like this. So I'm not gonna lie, it wasn't exactly the scariest thing. I think I flinched maybe once, and it was because, as most other people reviewing this have said, everybody else in the theater was like, oh, jeez, like just, you know, and everything else, and yeah. But it wasn't the worst movie, but you know, I mean, I gotta say, I watched number one, number two, and it didn't really do anything for me as much as those did either. It was just kind of the same thing.
How do you feel that how this one led into those? Like, this is like a pre-prequel.
It was like a pre-prequel, but it's like they kind of like to compare it to a different movie. Saw, I know, is like really gory and stuff like that, which is kind of different than this. But they really made the scare factor come in on that movie because they gave you all the details of what was going on. They put it right there in your head. But with this, they try to make up for a lot of the fear factor with, like, the absence of facts. It's they kind of try and make your brain think about what could possibly be happening and what could be, you know, going on. But it leaves you with a really vague storyline that you're kind of like, you know, is this what happened? You know, I don't know. Is this what's supposed to be going on? And it kind of, it just turns into a lot of jump scares and not really... You know, yeah, so.
Would you recommend people come see this in the theaters?
I know I'm going to be a total buzzkill by saying this, but probably not, just because, again, this is my opinion, and people know I'm, like, really hard-ass when it comes to movies. So there are very, very, very few movies I like. Not because I'm being hipster or something like that, but I guess it just comes with video editing and making videos and stuff like that. You have to, it takes a lot to really make you go like, wow, this is a crazy movie, you know?
What would you rate this movie out of 10?
I would say it's probably like a 5. Okay. I would say it's 5. I'm not going to say it's a 2. That's reserved for a few other movies I've seen this year. But it's definitely a 5, I would say. It's pretty down the line. Because I will say, I'll give him this. The special effects for the stuff like I'm not going to give it away what was happening. But the general special effects in the movie were really well done in terms of making it seem like it really was happening. Like, there's almost no way to tell that it was, like, green screened or, you know, this or that thrown around or whatever else. It's very, very well done with the special effects. And the general acting was good. And the acting was so good that the wife in the movie frustrated the absolute hell out of me with the way she behaved. Not giving away any spoilers past that, but if you watch 1 and 2, you'll probably get why I'm saying with that, where one character always makes you go insane.
Yeah.
Because it's like, why are you thinking this? It's like, you know.
Well, thanks a lot for coming with us, man. We appreciate
it. Well, I want to go to a bunch more like this, and hopefully I won't be a buzzkill for every single one. So
make sure, if you haven't heard of him yet, go to www.youtube.com/AzeriteReaction. His name is Desmond. He's awesome, does video games, and he's amazing.
You should go to his instead, because his is pretty damn awesome, too. So, yeah.
Thanks, man. We appreciate it, bro.
Thanks for sharing. Last week I asked you, what is your favorite prequel to a movie? Here's some of my favorite comments. My question for you this week, do you believe in ghosts? If you've had any paranormal experience, leave your answers in the comments section under this video as well. Click here to see what the viewers at Mike's Minute had to say about Paranormal Activity 3. If you've never watched the viewer's review and you don't know what it is, it's basically between 4 to 8 people that go to the movie with me, and some of them are regulars, some of them are new people each time, and they give their opinion about the movie. So it's like normal people watching a movie, since apparently I'm abnormal. Thanks for watching.
Oh, that's filthy. Filthy.